If you're running a UniFi network, this change is a big one. UniFi Network 9 just dropped, bringing some major upgrades. We've got Site Magic SD-WAN for seamless multi-site networking, a powerful new local network API, and UniFi's CyberSecure, which is a $99 a year threat management system that keeps your network protected. But they've also introduced a completely overhauled firewall system. Now, if you've ever struggled with UniFi's old interface-based firewall rules, you're gonna love this update. I'm talking about the zone-based firewall, which makes managing firewall rules much easier. No more scrolling through complex rule sets. Now you can see exactly what's blocked or allowed at a glance. Now this is a big shift for UniFi users, and to take a deep dive into how this works and what it means for your network, I'm gonna toss it over to Crosstalk's own David Barger, who has been digging into every detail so that you don't have to. All right, David, take it away.
Prior to the new zone-based firewall system, Ubiquiti was using an interface-based firewall system. This meant that the firewall rules fell under the category of an interface with a direction. Think LAN in, LAN out, LAN local. This worked just fine, but it was kind of tedious to see at a glance what the default action was for a certain rule set. You really just had to dig your heels in and read the whole way down through the rule set to see what was going on. What would normally end up happening would be you'd have this custom firewall rule set under LAN in, and it would just get to be very long, and anytime you wanted to make a change, you'd have to go through, refresh yourself, and then make the change you wanted. When we work with clients here at Crosstalk Solutions, often the first thing we do with them is consult on a firewall matrix. This walks through the various firewall rules that they want to implement for their org. This planning matrix looks just like this. Along the left-hand side, you'd see all of the sources detailed out, all the different VLANs and all the different locations we have on the network. And across the top, we'd have them mirrored. Down below in the middle, you see this color coding system that we use. Of course, red means that we're going to drop this traffic. Green means we're going to accept it, and yellow means it's a little bit complicated. I was pleased to see that UniFi's new firewall system kind of matches that. Let's dive in, I'll show you how they get this new feature enabled and how best to put it to work. We're working on my UDR here today, and we're logged into the UniFi OS console at unifi.ui.com. I just went to the little gear icon here and clicked security, and right away it's saying upgrade to the new zone-based firewall. Once you update the UniFi 9.0, you do have to enable this, and this is how you do it. You simply click upgrade, and it's going to give you some good information here about what this actually is. You should read down through this, and it's going to attempt to migrate over all of my existing firewall rules. And wow, that was pretty quick. It only took a second or two for mine to get migrated over. I assume if you have a bunch of firewall rules or a bunch of customizations, this could take a little bit more time. But let's take a look and see what's new in this version. Right away, up here at the top is the zone management system. This is where you manage all of your zones. Of course, the basics are already in here. Look at this. So the internal zone houses all of the internal LAN interfaces I already had. Management, ResearchNet, and then the Raptor Paddock cameras. They're automatically put inside of here. On top of that, a few other things got automatically added into a zone. Of course, the WAN got added to external, and then this restaurant guest network got added to the hotspot. Of course, if you had a lot of networks and you wanted to create your own zone, you could certainly do that and then reference that later in the firewall. Look down here at the zone matrix. I really like this. So straight away from the top level, we can see a source on the left-hand side and a destination across the top. And for example, here, internal to internal, it's lit up green and it says allow all. So we know by default right now, internal to internal traffic is allowed. And if we click on this, we can see the actual rule itself. There's also some here that are automatically blocked. For example, DMZ the hotspot or DMZ the DMZ. Nice bright red and it says block all. For the ones that are a little bit more complicated, it says view policies and then the number of policies. Let's take a look. So external to internal. So this is traffic that comes from the WAN and comes into our LAN. And whenever we click down into this, we can read this from the top down. It's only three rules. So the first piece is we allow our return traffic. Basically, traffic that was requested from the LAN will be allowed to return whenever it gets a response. Down below, we're blocking invalid traffic, and of course, then we have the block all traffic. By default, we don't want information coming in from the WAN and hitting the LAN unless it was requested, of course, from the inside. Now, beyond just giving us a view of this, we actually do have a few other features. Let's take a look at the internal network. Let's go ahead and create a policy. If you're familiar with the past version of UniFi OS, you know most of the time you had to select a source and destination, and that was mainly a network subnet, an IP address, or a group, which is basically a group of IP addresses or subnets. Now we have a few more options. Of course, you do have to initially select the source zone, but you can really get into the nitty-gritty here. First of all, you can go and select a specific device here, like for example my Pixel 8 Pro, and I can click save, and the firewall rule set will follow that device as long as the MAC address doesn't change. And it is important to note that things like iPhones and some Androids do randomize their MACs when they connect to a network. This would be more important for things like servers or NAS drives or something like that. And of course, we also have the option just to select a network, an IP address, or even a MAC address. And just like before, you can add in port information like specific ports, and they do have a whole list of them here for you to choose from. You certainly have to select an action for what you want this traffic to do, to be blocked, allowed, or rejected. The destination zone is just like the internal zone above. And then finally, down below here in this last section, we have some of the more advanced settings. These are all very similar to what we had before, but what I wanted to point out here that I really liked was the connection state. If you're familiar with stateful firewalling, you know that a connection can have a few different states that it's in. It can either be new, established, related, or invalid. This made it a bit more simple to understand all of those terms, such as all states, just return traffic, which I believe is established slash related traffic, and then custom. So if you do want to do your own stateful firewalling, you can go in here and select them. Overall, I think this zone-based firewall update from UniFi is a great update. There's definitely some quality of life enhancements, as well as just some features that we can really use here. At first, it can seem kind of daunting, but really it's just changing the layout of how this all works and giving us some extra features. As always, if anything here looked too complicated or you'd like a professional to review your system with you, you should reach out to us at rogue.support. Our technicians there are experts at zone-based firewalling, and they'd be happy to work with you on your system. Thanks for watching and subscribing to Crosstalk Solutions.